Hi, I'm Clemens, and welcome to the reveal of Hitman 3 Year 2. Here at IO Interactive, we've been building exciting new content for Hitman 3, and I'm super excited to share more details of what you can expect from another full year of support. First things first, Hitman 3 Year 2 will start on the 20th of January 2022. And today, I'm very excited to reveal some new details about what we've been working on. We've lined up some new reveals and details of two upcoming game modes and insights from our developers. So, let's jump straight into the reveal of something completely new. This is Elusive Target Arcade.
We are always thinking of new ways to challenge our players and give them fresh experiences within the world of assassination. Elusive Targets have always been about recreating an experience that is both tense and impactful. You get one chance to take down your target, there are no second chances, and failure is permanent. The Elusive Target Arcade is our way to take this concept to the next level. The formula has been the same for a while now, and we are ready to mix things up. But without sacrificing what made the Elusive Target so exciting in the first place. In this new mode, you'll take on the ultimate Elusive Target challenge and earn rewards as you go. This isn't just about taking down one target anymore. The Elusive Target Arcade tasks you with taking down several targets, one after the other, without failing and with new objectives and complications thrown into the mix. If you can complete the trial, you'll earn exclusive rewards that can be used in the rest of the game. And crucially, these trials will be permanent. Once they are added to the game, they'll be available and waiting for you whenever you are ready to play them. But if you fail a trial, you'll have to wait for the next day to give it another go. Through Year 2, we'll be updating the Elusive Target Arcade with more trials for you to take on and enjoy. We cannot wait to have you play the Elusive Target Arcade and let us know what you think.
Elusive Target Arcade will be available for all Hitman 3 owners starting on January 20. We've been talking about changing the Elusive Target formula for a little while now, and we're excited to share the first details of how you can enjoy Elusive Targets in a new way. Now for something else that's coming to the game on January 20. And this is specific for PC players.
We are super, super happy that we can finally release the whole Hitman Trilogy game and release it to the PC VR community.
The gameplay is perhaps even more exciting. And with the PC version, you have now two hands, two controllers, and you also have the movement of your body.
When we started working on it, I think one of the first things that we knew that we wanted to get in there was to have some more physicality in some of the movements, and throwing being one of the big parts in the whole trilogy, even in the flat game, we really wanted to nail that. So we added the same base system where you aim. Right now you aim with your left hand, so you target with your left hand, and then you fling and release with your right. And it sort of just worked out of the box. At least, I think we have some footage of Klaus trying it for the very first time.
And it just instantly clicked.
Yeah, it just worked. Yeah. And then it started having some, we found out it had some extra stuff that suddenly you could fling from, like an underhand throw.
Side.
Of a side throw, so you started being all ninja-like if you wanted to do, or like a juggler almost, yeah. Right?
And we have a lot of different items in the game, like shurikens, like you can really roleplay this like ninja fantasy, for instance, if that's your jam.
Yeah, we also put in, stuff like the left hand attaching to the right when you're holding a weapon. What else? The close combat with both hands now feels extremely satisfying, because you naturally go into this, I don't know, boxer stance or karate, if that's your vibe, right? Mm-hmm. So this level of freedom.
Running through a level, slapping everybody on the way, like turning around, throwing something, then picking up a gun, shooting. Like it turns into kind of a ballet sometimes, almost. And you can really express your inner, like what kind of version of 47 you are today.
Yeah, and I would say that, especially in combat, these more action-packed areas have really gotten a notch up, simply because you're not controlling an animation or a character anymore, it's you doing the movements, and that really makes you feel when you do it right, it makes you feel extremely badass, which is super, super.
Oh, extremely super elegant. Cool.
Elegant as well. Yes. And sometimes you feel like an idiot. That's what you do in Hitman, right? Yeah.
Yes. So we're super excited for everybody to be able to play it. It's happening right around the corner, and we can't wait to hear everybody's feedback and reactions and see what people figure out, what crazy ways they're going to play the game. And PC VR is very much.
What?
Have fun with it, really.
PC VR is looking amazing, and PC players can look forward to experience the world of assassination in a whole new way in year two. There's more to come for PC players a little later on, and we still have a new reveal of another game mode to come as well, so stay tuned for that. Now, let's check in with some more developers at IOI who will share fresh details on some of the technical improvements that are coming to the game during year two.
We're constantly working on our Glacier technology. It's powering our existing games and all our future games as well. And we want to use the year two of Hitman 3 as a chance to bring some of these improvements to our players early on.
Some of those improvements, ray tracing. We're going to have better reflections, we're going to have better shadows. You know, Hitman looks amazingly already, but imagine that with ray tracing. It's really, really good. And we are excited to bring it to you, like metals, waters, it's awesome. It's really looking very nice. And we're bringing this to you, 2022.
We're also continuing our partnership with Intel that brought so many cool advancements to Hitman 2 and Hitman 3 for PC gamers. This year, we're going up another notch and implementing, as one of the first studios, XeSS technology from Intel, which is going to be in the game soon.
One more, variable ray shading. It's a technique that is for graphic cards. What it makes is, depending on the load of the graphic cards, renders the frame one way or the other. This means better performance, better looking game, and more fun.
I'm sure you guys are going to love it.
That was more great news for Hitman 3 Year 2. Now, I want to share a few announcements about how we'll be welcoming new players and supporting new platforms this year. Firstly, we're happy to share with our PC players that Hitman 3 will arrive on Steam at the start of year 2, with full support of VR and all the technical improvements that you've just seen. If you're completely new to the world of assassination, we're making it easier than ever to get started and play the full campaign in one single package. The Hitman Trilogy includes Hitman 1, Hitman 2, and Hitman 3, giving you everything you need to jump straight into the world of assassination. And when Year 2 launches on January 20, the Hitman Trilogy will be available through the Xbox Game Pass catalog for both console and PC. All of our new and existing players have a lot to look forward to. And now, we're excited to share the first details of a major new game mode that is coming to Hitman 3 in just a few months' time. This is Freelancer.
In Freelancer, you have a safe house. You don't get everything served for you as you do in the main missions. Usually everything is ready and you just show up in Paris or wherever, but here you actually have to do a little bit of this planning beforehand. Yeah. And it does give a lot of the role-playing part of it is really strong, because you kind of feel like you are Hitman. Basically, you can also visit all your different parts of the safe house. These are customizable, so you can over time kind of configure how you think your hitman should live.
As 47, you are taking on some cool freelance contracts. You have to find some criminal enterprises that are destroying the world slowly, and you have to choose which one you really hate and go against them. So really, a campaign is a set of missions that spans across the world of assassination. So as a player, you should imagine going on a longer kind of campaign where you go to different missions and you choose the order you want to approach them in. So there's a lot of strategical considerations as well.
So this gives a very varied experience whenever you play new campaigns.
Yes, it combines the territories and the locations in new ways.
When you're on a campaign, you are going up against various types of crime, basically. First off, you have to try and corner the leader. You do that by going to different locations where you take down some of the more ordinary members, and these are sort of bread and butter missions, but it all leads towards you cornering the leader, and the last territory will basically be where the leader is. So you also have some choice there that you can sort of pick where you want to face the leader. When you get to the final mission, you don't know exactly who the leader is. You have some intel that will help you, but you still have to unravel who the actual leader is. So this is this feels very random when you play over and over again, that you can't really learn the missions. You have to think every time. On these final missions, the leaders will also have additional help from their organization. There's some NPCs that are hidden, but are very deadly. So you have to look out for those. There's also other NPCs that will basically spook the leader and alert the leader, so he or she will escape. So there's an added layer of difficulty.
Every success in Freelancer basically comes down to your own skill and wits and creativity. Freelancer is very inspired by roguelike games. So we are adding way more consequence to what happens when you're on a mission than we normally do in the normal Hitman games and other game modes.
During the missions, there will be suppliers that you can purchase gear from. So that's a new thing. And this is the way you actually build your arsenal in Freelancer. This gear is not persistent. So it means that if you bring it on a mission and actually die or drop it, then it's gone. So then you have to purchase it again, basically. Mm-hmm. So there's another layer of tension here that you can't just get a lot of stuff for free. You actually have to build your arsenal and maintain it. Consumables will, of course, be gone when you use them. So you have to stock up on that. There's no backup plan. It's the sweaty palms we're going for.
When you are in your safe house, then you have all the time in the world to plan, and you can figure out what to do. But when you have taken that plane and you are on location, then you better make it count.
Freelancer is looking incredible and is currently in the final stages of development. It's currently scheduled for release in spring 2022, and we can't wait. We're nearing the end of the show. So let's recap. Today we introduced Elusive Target Arcade, a game mode that takes elusive targets to a new level. We're bringing Hitman VR to PC, and Hitman 3 will be arriving on Steam. Ray tracing is coming to PC, and the entire world of Assassination Trilogy will be included in Xbox Game Pass 2. Finally, we shared the first details on Freelancer, an exciting new mode that will change the way you play and bring back Agent 47's safe house. I can't wait. All of that will be part of Hitman 3 Year 2 in the coming months. There's just one more thing I want to share before the end of the show. We have promised that there is more to come later this year. So here's the first look at something we're working on for later in year 2. Agent 47 just doesn't stop traveling.